Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here in San Antonio at WebTegrity, where we do all things WordPress. We're a small group of web nerds that develop custom WordPress themes, and we also teach WordPress and we teach SEO fun stuff. So if you're interested in any of that, be sure to check out our website. Today's topic is how to update a WordPress purchased theme. So if you were to go out there and decide that a free option really just isn't the solution for your WordPress website and you want to pay to purchase a premium theme, you can certainly do that. Some of the authors are very generous to allow you to attach a license key into your dashboard that then allows you to have automated updates. That is so generous of them. But that is a very rare case in this time. So now what we're seeing is you actually have to go back to the point of purchase, download the most recent version of that theme, and then what do you do with it? So that's kind of the process here. We just had WordPress 4.5 released, and a lot of people's websites broke. So, you know, your theme might have conflicted now with that update. So what do you do? How do you go in and make those changes? Well, let's get to it. We're going to actually be using FTP to do this. So a couple of steps you have to do in the first place, okay? Very first thing I want you to do is log in your dashboard and be sure that you have an update in our backup rather in place, okay? So we use Updraft Plus. This is a free plugin to back up your current website. So you'll see that I just did that. I backed up the current website. You want to be sure to back up the files and database. See how this says that? Files and database. You always want to be sure to have a backup in place. We preach that here on our WordPress Wednesday channel. Be sure to have a backup consistently happening on your website, and this particular plugin can do that for you. So you can save it to your Dropbox, you can save it to a couple other places, you can save it directly to your server. So if we have any issues as we're updating our theme now, we know we can restore and not miss any downtime. So this is a great safety net. Once you've run that backup in place, you'll want to pop over to Appearance and go to Themes to help you remember which theme you're using. For this particular website, we are using the Austin theme, and that is from Theme Forest. And we have a child theme in place as well, which is the Austin child theme. So the difference with child themes, and I'll put a link in the description box below so you can go learn more about them, is if you have made changes specifically to the PHP files in a theme, those changes could easily be overridden as we go through this process right now to update our theme. So if you're a little confused on should I have a child theme in place first, click the link below and you can go over and check out why a child theme is needed and when it is not needed. All right, so a little bit of difference there, but we want to keep moving forward here with updating this theme. So whenever you update a theme, you're updating always the parent theme. And you'll go back to point of purchase, which for us was Theme Forest for this particular theme, and we're coming here to Austin. Now, to know whether or not you need to do this, you can click on this and see that it says version 1.8. If you're seeing some breaks happen on your website, if something went a little wonky after you updated something, it could be that this particular version is now out of date and you need to update. So we came over here to Austin to take a look to see if the theme had recently been updated, and in fact, it had been. Just last week, it's been updated. So if you scroll down a little bit further, typically in this area, you can find that WordPress is compatible with 4.5, that this theme is compatible with 4.5, and that they are now on version 2.1 of the Austin theme. So ours is definitely out of date and we need to update it. So you'll come here to the downloads area. When you click on this, specifically inside of Theme Forest, you would click on installable WordPress files only. This is what we want to download. This will download our most recent version of this theme. If you're purchasing your theme from somewhere else, a different website or different author, you're more than welcome to just kind of engage with them, see what their support forums say. Sometimes documentation inside of these themes will help you with this process as well, step by step, giving you very clear instruction. If you haven't been able to find that, that's probably why you're watching this video. All right, so once you have all that in place, you will need to have access to FTP. So FTP can be something that you use for free. It can also be something that your hosting provider gives you. So a dashboard where you get access to your files. What we're trying to do is once we've downloaded that theme now, what you want to do is go into your website's server area. And that's what this site is over here. We've dialed into the server area for this one particular website. And then this left side over here is my computer. So this is my download here where I've downloaded the Austin theme. So in order to get to the right spot inside of FTP, you're going to drill into a couple of different folders. You're going to go to WP Content, open that up. We're going to drill into Themes, open that up. And you should see whatever themes that you have installed on your dashboard. You should see those here. So we do have one called Austin, and this is the one we want to overwrite. So I am just going to click on this and go ahead and upload it. It should give me an alert here. Let's see, there it is, saying, are you sure you want to overwrite everything? Because you've got something already named that over here. And we want to say overwrite. And for now, we're going to say overwrite everything. So here it goes. This could be a little bit of a process, so just for the sake of time, and so you don't have to stare at me on the screen, I'm going to pause the video and we'll be right back. Well, gosh, that totally took forever, so I'm really glad I paused that video. Everything is complete now. You see here that the Austin theme is over here and the transfer is successful. So let's take a look at our website and make sure, I'm going to click refresh. I just want to make sure that, let's see if I can get this going here. I just want to make sure that our break that we saw happening is still functioning correctly. And then what we also want to do is just be sure that everything looks correct still on the theme. So this little hover over effect was what was broken on this theme and was not functioning correctly with 4.5 WordPress. And everything else looks correct. Our customization to our colors are still here. Of course, all of our content is still here. And now that one little thing that was a little wonky, not functioning correctly, is working perfectly. So that's kind of the process. First things first, be sure you have a backup in place. Second thing, be sure that you even need to do this. So make sure that the author's already created a new updated version of the theme. Jump over there, see if there's documentation specifically from that author to kind of help you walk through this process. And of course, a better case scenario is if that author was generous enough to give you a license that you can just apply to your dashboard and automatically have those updates in place. So you don't have to do the whole FTP process. I hope that helps you. If you have questions about this, and some of you might, go ahead and put them in the comments below and I'll try to answer them as soon as I can. I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday, and stick around because next week, be sure to subscribe. I am finally going to put together my list of top 10 favorite free responsive WordPress themes for 2016. See you next week. Bye, y'all.